Hey guys, we are Peter's Pub. It's 10 o'clock. Getting ready for the big game. Brown's going to beat the Steelers. This is Mr. Greg Deegan, who wrote the book Surviving the Drought. Tell us about him.
Well, pretty much. I firmly believe that there is no group of fans in the country that are more unique and more passionate about their sports teams than Cleveland fans. And I wrote a book to tell the sporting world and to tell the rest of the owners and Cleveland fans around the country how unique they are. Because for 43 years, it's been a lot of heartbreak and hopelessness at times, and it is constant. The passion still is turned up every Sunday. Pretty impressive. So it's a book to honor Cleveland sports fans like you.
So we're expecting about probably 150 people here. This is Jeff Shirilla. He is now a celebrity in town, and looks like he's off his diet.
It's a special occasion. What can I say?
Wow! Look at that. Nice. Breakfast, Pittsburgh Browns backer stuff. Charlotte, and where?
Keys Rocks.
The Rocks. You've been here before, right?
Yeah, I've seen it.
How you doing?
So where did you hear about us?
Our friend Aaron.
Where are you guys from?
Broadview Heights.
And look who's here. It's Bridget.
Whoa,
Zika.
Bees are here.
Look at the brown and orange donuts. Yeah.
And then it took me about a half an hour to find out what bridge to cross and what one way to go down. And cool.
I remember a moment. It was at the beginning of the fourth quarter. The Browns are driving.
So where are you guys from?
Wadsworth, south of Cleveland, Ohio.
Oh, we know where that is.
Yep. So, I don't know if you guys remember this, but Kelly Holcomb, who seemed at that moment to be Canton bound, because he was playing so amazingly.
I won the heaviest Browns banner award.
Do you remember that, Jeff? Do you remember that jacket? We had like a jacket that was 10 feet too big.
They were driving, and it was like third down, like at the five. He rolls out and tries to hit Jamal White. He falls incomplete, and they settle for a field goal.
Did the jacket even fit you?
No. That was 60 pounds ago.
And I turned to my wife, and I said, that's it. They just lost the game. It's like, the momentum's going in favor of the Steelers. We're done. And she looked at me, and she said, you are a freak. Look at the score. It's been amazing. The Browns are going to kick their butts. And I said, you just have no idea what it's like to be a Cleveland fan. You have no idea. So, of course, final score, Pittsburgh 36, Browns 33. The phone calls from my in-laws, adding the salt to that 37-year wound I've been sporting of being a Cleveland sports fan. And I realized that...
I live in Sherman, originally from Northeast Ohio. Hainesville, Ohio.
The rest of the sporting world needs to know what it's like to be a Cleveland sports fan, to live and die with every team year in and year out, despite the fact that it's 43 years and counting.
Cops are here. Cops are here. I'm going to get this on video in case they take Paul to the tank tonight.
I've got actually a number for you that might be a little bit depressing, but I think it's something that you should be proud about. We should be proud about.
All right, final score predictions.
33-30, Cleveland. 17-21, Cleveland.
The Browns, the Cavs, and the Indians have suited up now for 9,500 games.
Are you at the wrong bar or what, sir?
Since our last championship, and have not yet been crowned yet. We're coming upon 10,000 soon. So that's amazing. Keep the faith.
Do you have a death wish for your brother?
He's the one that came upstairs. I didn't bring him up.
I had to write this book because I really firmly believe, and I sent it to Mike and Mike and all over, to basically make the argument that Cleveland sports fans are by far and above any other sports fans in the country, the most diehard. So, you know, I interviewed a bunch of, you know, Sam Attigliano and Jim Donovan and Terry Pluto, and I interviewed about 200 Browns fans to get their stories, and they're really, I hate, they're hilarious. I mean, there's a lot of books out there about the sports moments, but actually talking to Browns fans, a lot of Browns backers, they're awesome. They kept me going, because it could be depressing when you write a book about Cleveland sports in the last 40 years.
Receiver got 2 feet in about. Yeah!
I'm telling you, from funny stories at parties to, you know, when I asked someone, like, what was the most memorable thing about going to the Indians games when they were so bad, and he said, you know what I remember? It was so empty that we used to look at the binoculars, and I'd throw our binoculars up into the upper deck behind left field, and you could watch two people having sex. Anyway, I appreciate you having me. I'm going to be in Columbus for Columbus Browns backers in Akron as well. So I appreciate you having me. Cleveland Browns fans are far and above the greatest. And by the way, numbers wise for the Browns, we're going on 700 games without being crowned a champion. So, but it's coming soon. I can feel it. So anyway, thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
I'm the president of the Pittsburgh Browns backers, and we do our own interviews here, so I just wanted to know what your assignment was today.
Just like a story about the rivalry between Cleveland and Pittsburgh, and then we're just kind of unique here at this bar because you have the Browns fans upstairs.
Who let the dogs out?
Was nice, the party was pumping.
Hey, yeah. V-I-O.
And everybody having a ball.
V-I-O.
Until the fellas start the name calling.
V-I-O.
And the girls respond to the call. I have a poor one shout out.
Who let the